أعزائي المشاهدين، أهلا وسهلا بكم من جديد مع برنامجكم الأسبوعي برنامج إماراتي. كما عودناكم في كل أسبوع نستضيف لكم خيرة من دولة الإمارات. قصة نجاح أتتنا إلى الدولة منذ تسعينيات القرن الماضي. مستر روي، good afternoon.
Good afternoon, doctor.
We are so lucky to be here with you and your company. Our team said you welcome in our program and we would like to know about yourself. Who's Roy when he comes to this country at the first time and what he's doing at this moment.
So who's Roy is a very deep question to ask. So I will ask you, I will respond to you with who's Roy on the business front. So on the business front, I graduated from university in Washington DC, studied civil engineering and did my master's in engineering as well. Came to the UAE in 1998 to head an electromechanical company that my dad had started in 1966 in Sharjah. And headed the company, grew it over the 10-year period, that 98 to 2006, and did not really enjoy the field I was in, so decided to stop pursuing a career that was only based on financial goals and pursue a career that was based on passions. So I evaluated my passions, and one of them was the boating industry, and this is when in 2005 Aces Boat was born, a company that does boats for the leisure market initially.
The passion starts from 8 years, when you have 8 years only. So how it's come to you? How the passion you start finding?
So on a summer holiday in Spain, my grandfather bought me a small boat similar to the one that we do, and he took me out to an island from the mainland. And I fell in love with boating and the sea in this moment at 8 years old. And this is when I said to myself that in the future, I want to be in the boat business.
2005, you take the decision to start your own company. Let's talk about the main concept that we do it. What was it?
One of the companies that my dad had established was the electromechanical company, and one of the products was water tanks, which is a fiberglass product. So we had the know-how of fiberglass or composite manufacturing in-house, and one of my passions was car racing, and boating is a passion, so I combined the know-how of composite fiberglass with the mechanical and electrical know-how that I had from my car racing, and then the boat was born.
Our concept is get approved from everywhere, even if you go to the army section, when you join the army section.
So it was very hard to, when we started, the beginning was very hard for us. First of all, we were the only player in the rigid inflatable boats in the whole area, in the whole Middle East and even Africa. So acceptance of such a product was hard. And we started in the leisure market in 2005. In 2008 and 2009, when the financial crisis hit, I realized that the leisure market took a beating, and I needed to have a business model that was most sustainable over the cycles of the economy. And this is when we started to get into the professional and government contracts for boats. It was very hard initially to be accepted, but the UAE Coast Guard gave us the trust because of the name that we had built over the past years with the contracting company, and gave us a chance to start. And from there, now we sell to 80 different countries around the world.
When Dubai accept our product, it's mean one of the best, because Dubai always choose number one. Number one, when we talk about it, we need to mention His Highness Sheikh Mohammed. When he mentioned for us, it's hard to be number one, but the hardest to stay on the same level. Why we are here? Because you are one of the best. Still keep on the top. How you keep yourself in the top?
Okay, so for me, Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed and Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid, both have been role models for me in the vision and in the execution of the vision that they have, in being number one and being always on top of the world, actually. And I was influenced by them to bring the same mindset to my company. It wasn't easy to be number one from day one, and we were not number one from day one. But through constant innovation, we were able to reach to a level where we are now number one in the world, not in the Middle East. And it's innovation. And we constantly innovate. And the innovation is about answering our customers' pain points. So seeing where are their pains and finding solution to give them a pain pill is what I call.
So many you are making the body or from A to Z for the boats?
So we are fully vertically integrated. So the fact that we were the first one to do such boats in the area, we had no know-how to tap in locally. We had to tap in with international know-how, and I could not be dependent on it. So I brought everything in-house. So today we are fully vertically integrated. And we are actually the only boat company in our field that is fully vertically integrated, and that's a major part of our success.
When we talk about the quality, when we talk about the materials that we will use, including this sustainable area, so do we have any sustainable project?
Okay, so the quality is very important for us. Let's start with that. There is many different standards in the boating industry, and we are on top of all the standards. So I chose the best standard in the world, and I said, this is the standard I want to follow, all right? So, and this was the reason why we were able to export to so many countries. Sustainability, so when you ask me who is Roy or who I am, my typical answer would be, I am loving awareness, right? And for me, respect to humans, nature, and animal is on the top of my priority. And sustainability is the respect of nature. And we are, so based on that, not only are all our people taken care of in a very special way, but also our factory has solar panels, and we are carbon negative on the boat business.
So when you get this idea, or when you start to be zero carbon, let's talk about, because nobody think about it so much more.
So that's a personal calling of mine. I was not pressured into it. It's something that I always believed we should do. I mean, electricity cost is not high. It's not a reason to save money. For me, it was purely environmental issue and aligned with who I am.
Mr. Roy, always when we start a new idea, our family or our relative always give us an advice, so they accepted or they would be against. So when you get the idea, when you start the idea, the family was approved for it?
So initially, no. That was quite funny, is that no one believed in it. But stubborn like I am and focused like I am, I went all out. And and I told you about Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed. 10 years ago, we were in IDEX, in the Abu Dhabi defense show. And he came to our stand and he put his hand on my shoulder and told me, you will succeed. You will be a success story for the UAE. And this for me was like a father giving me his blessing. And this is what the energy I took from and used to bloom to where I am today.
Always we are saying behind a businessman there is a woman, but we can say now behind Mr. Roy, Sheikh Mohammed.
Sheikh Mohammed for sure was the driving force and the motivation force. But my wife is the one that is on a day-to-day basis supporting me for sure.
How is she supporting you?
She's supporting me by allowing me to grow and allowing me to reach where I want to reach without anchoring.
When we choose the business to open, so always we need to choose our family that will be with together. The employee is important in our business, so how did you choose your employee?
So initially, we already had a company going, right? So I knew who were the good assets. And for me, it's all by referral. So anyone that's working in the company was to refer people that were aligned with our value system, and basically all our employees are by referral.
How we can build the relation with our employees to keep the company together all the time?
Okay, it's by being humble and by understanding that without them you have nothing. And for me, it's they come first.
Corona came, changed the concept of the everything in this world. So many companies stopped, many employees. Did you terminate any employees?
Not one employee was terminated, and everyone was taken care of as if before Corona.
After Corona, we start going for online way. So also your company?
So we run on the Agile system, which is a way to align the team and get things executed. We were doing offline, but it was very easy for us to move online with that management system. And we are still using the benefit of the online now with the multiple regional offices that we have.
Artificial intelligence is connected with online now. So did we have any activity with AI?
So we're looking into AI right now for our chat, live chat on our website. Mm-hmm. So right now when you go on, you can send an email to contact us, or you can have a live chat with one of our sales team. So we're making a pool of knowledge now so that AI can reply and not the person reply. And in our CRM, we're even making the quotation process and sending the work order to the factory through the AI.
When we join the company now, so I see many certificates and things from many people over the world. And we don't talk about low level or medium, all of them high level when you get the certificates.
So we're talking about certificate for company and certificate for products.
Yes.
Right. So for us, given that we are an international company selling all over the world, we need to have the certification to give credibility to our company. Mm-hmm. So we went for both the company certification and the product certification. And we are certified to sell anywhere in the world. And the company is ISO on all fronts.
And the thanks certificates?
Which one?
The thanks certificates from over the government over the world, the awards that you get it.
Ah, the awards, yes. So the awards are not important to me. For me, what's important is giving unconditionally. So one of the questions that I'm always asked is the balance between work, life. And for me, it's the most important is to have a proper balance. And the balance is between my work, my family, my community, and myself. So my community is where I give back to the community, and that's where all the certificate of appreciation come. But for me, it's unconditional, and I like to give back.
So Mr. Roy, with horses, cars, and boats, give us this company. Where we go now? What's the next plan in the business?
So I would tell you to space, but no, not yet to space. Now, right now, we're expanding our manufacturing capacity for more volume geographically. So we have a factory in the US that's already set up, and we have one being set up in the next 6 months in Saudi Arabia.
Always our character is built by our father. So the father is the first one who affect the man. How or what the main thing you take from your father with your business life?
So my father was the igniting force behind my entrepreneurial journey. He was an entrepreneur since age 12. And I never worked anywhere. After university, I decided right away to be an entrepreneur, and this is the way he brought me up to be. So it's all thanks to him, for sure.
When you be a father or for the company that have more than 1,000 employees, when you talk about the father for the home families, when you talk about the businessman and personal life, how you schedule your time between all these parts?
So the balance that I was talking to you about is the most important for me. So work, family, community, and myself. And I make sure to balance these, otherwise you will fail in some of them and be successful in all. My decision was to be as successful as I can across these four fronts.
Always UAE is a hub for the world and a hub for everyone who finishes education that he want to come here to start his new life. Many newcomers coming to this country as employees or investors. So what the first advice giving for everyone coming to this country?
So my first advice would be come, right? And when they come is be humble, work hard, and don't be distracted by things that you might be distracted with. Stay focused on your mission, on your vision, and have full trust in the country.
Where we can find you online? So, have a website, applications, media, how we can find you?
So online, the company is online, very present, whether through news agencies, TV interviews, website, and you can find us also physically. We're in most of the trade shows that are related to boats. That's how you will find us.
Finally, this country that give us something, you cannot find it over the world. This country started from His Highness age, Sheikh Zayed, the one who started the first step. Son of that, Zayed, they make UAE number one in the world. First thing, they are respect the human, peace and safe country, and all opportunity for everyone over the world. So what do you say for the leaders and government for this opportunity that give it to us?
I would like to thank the leaders of the UAE, the founding fathers as well. So I've been here since 1998, so I saw the time of Sheikh Zayed, and now I am living under the time of Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed and Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid. I'd like to thank them for the peace that they've created in this country, the infrastructure they've created for the country, and all the help they've provided for everyone in the UAE across all different nationalities, religions, and the acceptance that they have given us. The vision and the execution is a role model for us. And it's very important to be in a country where you can follow the leaders in their vision, because ultimately you will be successful by just following what they do.
And from our side, we will thank you so much for spending your time with our team, and welcome again our program. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. تسلك عقل وروح فروا مدن وجبال حاجة ترى